Hello, viewer. My name's Don, and I do appreciate your company on this tour of Government House, Darwin, Northern Territory, Australia. Government House, occupied by His Honour, Mr. Ted Egan, the administrator of the Northern Territory, is only open for 3 hours twice a year. We were lucky enough to be able to visit on Friday, 14th of July, 2006, from 4:30 to 7 p.m. It was quite an experience. From the front gate, this is what you see. The house is called the House of Seven Gables because it's got seven peaks. It's very easy to find because it's located behind this Parliament House overlooking Darwin Bay. Government House was originally built in 1870, rebuilt in 1878 by European prisoners and Chinese laborers. It was badly damaged during Cyclone Tracy in 1974 and is still the official residence of the administrator of the Northern Territory. A very nice cover brochure is available that tells you a bit about Government House. One can also join a foundation by paying a membership to help support Government House and provide information about Government House. The brochure also includes lots of nice photographs of the interior of Government House, including the drawing room and the Prince of Wales room, occupied at one time by the Prince of Wales during a visit in 1988. The Queen's bedroom was actually occupied by Queen Elizabeth in 1982 during a visit. There's some beautiful verandas right around the house. Dining room is used for formal occasions and is very large. There's also the outdoor terrace for more informal dining. Ted Egan provided a wonderful brochure, and if you check out the website, there's a great deal of information about the house and the role of the administrator. Government House occupies just over a hectare, and the brochure that Mr. Egan provided describes the house and the gardens, which are magnificent. It's also well worthwhile checking out the website, but I'll show you a quick picture of the website to give you the idea of how it looked in July 2006. The site gives you a good idea of the duties of the administrator, such as presenting the government policy speech, making statutory appointments, and representing the Queen at a huge range of functions. The current administrator is Ted Egan, who I met in 1981 when he attended the 2J Folk Festival in Western Australia as an honoured folk singer. It was very interesting reading about his background. The Master of Arts in History, a Bachelor of Arts done in the bush, and of course the honorary doctorates. Ted's actually recorded about 28 CDs of Australian folk songs and has written numerous songs. Well, let's have a quick look at the garden. We'll look at the information first. There's a lot of garden and I'm in a wheelchair and most of it's inaccessible to me. So I'm unable to really show photographs of each particular little garden, such as the rain tree hillside or the retainer wall garden. Tourists, however, really seem to enjoy wandering around through the bamboo and the eastern hillside with its native and exotic species. I would have liked to get to the shade house and certainly visit the gazebo with some of its photographs. The terrace was originally a tennis court. A swimming pool was built and then the pool was relocated. Today as many as 500 guests can be entertained at the terrace. There's a nice little garden around the terrace. This map is invaluable for touring the gardens and also recognizing the various rooms, from the Queen's bedroom through the drawing room to the Prince of Wales room and the dining room. This section to the left was out of bounds. We'll quickly go through a few photographs of the garden. This is a small Japanese garden. Tropical vegetation is very lush, supported by the hot, humid monsoon season during the months of January and February. Areas that are not very friendly for a wheelchair. The outlook from the front of the government house is straightly into the parliament buildings. Imagine only having to walk to work about 10 meters. I've got no idea what this is. More walkways through the gardens. Right up on the terraces and Billy Shepherd. Ceremonial poles. And a photograph follows, specially commissioned for the gardens by six Aboriginal artists. They do look interesting, but I don't really understand their significance. Now we'll take a look at the House of Seven Gables. The terrace is on the left and it's filled with guests visiting. Tea and coffee and a light meal was served. I had a red carpet welcome. Ted greeted me and shook my hand, along with 300 guests. He's an extremely social fellow who mingled the entire 3 hours, as well as performing publicly with his folk songs. I was very impressed. A folk band entertained us for the entire time, and Ted Egan joined the band to sing some of his recorded songs. I remember some of his songs from the 2J Folk Festival in 1981. I sort of recall the spirit of Australia and life in the North. He's got great respect for the Aboriginals. He used to play VB, that's Victoria Bitter Beer Box, while he sang. Now we're on the veranda of Government House. It's completely enclosed by these shutters, which can be shut during a storm or cyclone. This room has pictures or paintings of previous administrators, as well as Aboriginal art, a magnificent chandelier, and a very high ceiling with fans for the tropical heat. I guess this might be the drawing room or living room where they can sit and relax. What a magnificent mirror. The state dining room has been all set out with crystal glasses and lovely Aboriginal paintings in the background. A sideboard for coffee and wine. The queen's bedroom with two queen-size beds, and this is only half the bedroom. The other half is set up as a sitting room, TV room. The other side of the queen's bedroom. Ted Egan's private workbench. A little bit of history. The interesting thing about this piano is the portrait of the Queen, Queen Elizabeth II. The administrator, of course, is like the Lieutenant Governor in Canada, appointed indirectly by the Queen and representing the power of the Queen. Paintings of previous administrators. I love this portrait of an old Aboriginal elder. Well, dear, we're almost done, and my friend Richard descended to the basement. No, there was no wine cellar, but there was a collection of old bottles. There are many collections of historical photographs around the house for the tourists. It was very educational. Many photographs like these. Thanks, viewer, for joining me, Richard and myself, on this tour of Government House. We leave you with a picture of car number one, the governor's car. We were given permission to take photographs around the house. I was surprised, but lots of tourists were doing it, and it was all permissible. Thanks for joining us, and have a great day.